Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. Do you want a shared calendar within your team so that other people can see events or vacations or birthdays that are going on, but actually not get invited to them? Because there are shared calendars in Teams. There's lots of them you can add in. In fact, there's a channel calendar that you can add in immediately and have it share all meetings with all of your team members. But that puts an appointment in your calendar. If you want to just look at appointment or look at events that are not your appointments, then this might be a way of doing it. So there's more than one way of doing this. I'm showing you an idea that's built right within Microsoft 365. So I'm going to be using the list feature to create a view that shows the items in the list as a calendar. So what you see in front of me here is a vacation calendar, and this vacation calendar is in my team, and the information that is showing on this calendar is coming from the list. And so right to the left of it, I'll just click here. And you'll see that this is the vacation list that the vacation calendar was made from. So this is a list that's within the team. This is a Microsoft list, is a 365 application available to you within the Microsoft 365 product line. There's no extra fee for this, and it's as easy as you hitting the plus sign and saying you want a list, and then from there adding in your columns. So I won't show you how to do the lists in this video. I'll show it to you in another video, but I want to show you how to create the calendar from a list here. So I have another example of a list, events for my staff, and I want to show you this as a calendar view. So right now you're seeing it as a list. So it's important to have a place to actually write down what events are coming up. And so somebody should be updating this list all the time, but it might be nicer to see this information in a calendar form. So that's what we're going to do next. So to do that, we have to go into SharePoint, and that's where the structure of that calendar list will happen. So I'm going to hit the three dots here, and from the three dots, I can say open in SharePoint, and away I go. Okay, I'm in SharePoint now. Same list as I was looking at within Teams, but within SharePoint, I have a lot of choices as far as the structure that can happen with this list. And that's where I'm going to choose to say, I want to look at this list as a calendar. So to do that, we need to go to Settings, which is the gear at the top right. And from Settings, we're going to say List Settings. Click on that. And from this menu, we're actually going to go all the way to the bottom and choose to create a view. Now, depending on what information is in your list, there are multiple views you can choose from. Because this list I'm looking at has dates, I have the calendar view as an option. If you had no dates, you wouldn't have calendar view as an option. Also, my view happens to have locations with addresses, so a map view is an option for how I view this list as well. But in this case, we want to look at it as a calendar view, so we're going to choose that. And we're essentially creating a new way of looking at this list. So we'll still have the list as a list, but we want to have a second way of viewing the information on this list, and that's what this view is all about. So we need to give this view a name, and then we need to organize how it looks. So my view name will be events list. And then because this is a calendar view, I need to tell it what the beginning point of any item on this list is, or any appointment or event on this list is, and what the ending point is. So it wants to know what column in my list pertains to that. So I'm going to click on the drop down. And my beginning point is event date. I don't really have an end point because I didn't say it starts at 2 and it ends at 4. I just put it as one event time. So just know that you could do that. So I'll choose event date in both cases. And then I've got a number of ways of looking at this calendar. It could be monthly view, weekly view, or daily view. And so when I'm looking at any one of those views, what is it that I want to see in the calendar? So it's that title of the event that I want to see in the calendar. It's whether it's a barbecue or whether it's a softball game. So I'm going to choose under choose a column, click on that, and I'm going to find title, and I'm going to choose that for each one of these views. Now I can have a subheading, so I can have other information on my weekly view and my daily view. And so that other information might be helpful here in the case of an event. Maybe I want to say what the location of that event is, like what the street address is, or you know, what the city is, or whatever makes sense there. So I'm going to choose heading, and we'll say location name. Okay, so we have all that set up. Now let's go down and see what other options we have to choose for this calendar. So I started by showing you a monthly calendar. You know that's possible. So let's show you what this looks like as a weekly calendar. So I'm going to click on that. And then it has an option to show all items in my view. And I do want to do that as opposed to filtering out some items. And then at the very bottom, how many items do I display in the list view web part? Now, web part pertains to a SharePoint area. So if I was looking at this list as a calendar view in SharePoint, how many items do I want to see at a time before I have to scroll? We're not looking at this particular calendar view in SharePoint. We're looking at it from Teams in this example that I'm sharing you. So it kind of doesn't pertain to us here, but nonetheless, I'll still change it to maybe 10 items to display. So if I ever do want to make a calendar view within the SharePoint site, I've got this option to see 10 items or events at a time. So I'll choose OK to that. And there you go. We see this week we've got a birthday lunch for Joe and a company barbecue. And then if I arrow across to next week, a lot of stuff's going on next week. Most of it after hours, but lots of stuff happening nonetheless. So let's have this show in Teams because we're still in SharePoint at this point. We're seeing this calendar view in SharePoint. So to move it into Teams, what we're going to do is grab the URL of it. So we're just going to go up to the line where we have the web address, and we're just going to, I just clicked on there, and we're going to right click, choose copy, and then we're going to go back to Teams. So I'm back in Teams and I want to add a tab for this calendar. I still want the events for staff as a tab because I want to list it out and have a place to update that list. But I also want a place for people to view it as a calendar. So now the tab that I'm going to add is not a SharePoint tab or a list tab, but a website tab because I want to have that view that I saved. So I'm going to go to website and I can have a name for this. So we'll call it events calendar, and then the URL, we'll paste that in and we'll save that. And there you have it. We're in the team and we have the events calendar showing within the team so that our team members can see what events are coming up this week and next week, and they'll always be in the know and have a quick access to it. All right, so try that yourself. Have fun. Bye-bye.